I think about the heart, I think about how complex it is. And really, its main function is to support every other part of our bodies. And so it's really one of the most critical organs in the body. But at surface level, it's just a pump, right? But there's so much going on and so many cells that have to be working together perfectly for that pump to function. And that's really what I'm interested in, is how all of these different entities sort of come together to actually make it work and make it push blood to every tissue in our body. A lot of the cells that we need for building a new heart aren't something we can just readily get from our own bodies. Our heart can't fix itself like a lot of other tissues can. Think if you get a scratch on your skin, eventually that's going to completely heal. That doesn't happen in the heart. So we need a different population of cells to be able to put into the heart so it'll function. And that's where stem cells come in. I work with a population of cells that are called induced pluripotent stem cells. And basically what that is taking a cell from somewhere in your body. And the ones that we mostly work with in the lab are from a skin sample. So we took those skin cells, turned them back in time to completely forget that they were skin, and they become stem cells. Then we can take those stem cells and give them different chemical factors that would normally be found during development to actually have them become beating heart cells. And so we can go from somebody's skin cell back to a stem cell over to a heart cell in a matter of a few weeks to a month. And so this is something I will never get tired of in my lab. I love walking in and just seeing, you can actually see these cells beating in a dish. So you imagine what your heart might look like, right? It's constantly beating and contracting. Well, that's exactly what these dishes look like. You just put them on the microscope and the whole dish is moving, the cells are contracting together like they do in the heart. Ultimately, the dream is to be able to develop these cells or these tissues or constructs that can be used for regenerative therapy, so actually putting into patients to restore heart function. But I think an intermediate between those two steps is also using these models as platforms to screen drugs. So cardiotoxicity is one of the leading causes of drug candidate failures because we don't have great models to be able to test what the response is going to be on humans. This is human-based tissue that we're working with. Remember, it was once somebody's human skin. And so we have a human-based platform that we can test different pharmaceutical compounds to see how the heart would respond and if there is any toxic effects prior to actual clinical trials. And the more complex our models are, the more accurate those responses are going to be. And so I can see these platforms as being used as basic science tools to understand normal and pathological physiology, as test beds for pharmaceutical compounds, and ultimately as translatable cell therapies and tissue therapies. I'm Tracy Hookway, an assistant professor in the biomedical engineering department at Binghamton University.